Formatting can be used to improve readability and usability of reports and call out important information. In this video, you will see how to set font size, bold text, set the background color, remove grid lines, change the location of a visualization's legend, change borders, and set conditional styles to use color to highlight results. This is the report that will be developed during the video. Starting with a new report, selecting the two-row template. I'm going to use the blue theme. And for my data source, I'm going to use the banking losses data. When my report opens, the first thing I notice is that the theme has been applied to my report titles. Clicking the title, I can give it a name. I can apply a font. Clicking the plus sign, I'm going to add a visualization. And in this case, I'm going to add a line chart. Coming over to my sources, I expand it. Take a year, double clicking, it goes into the x-axis. Net loss goes into the y-axis. And I'm going to drop region into color. So right now, I don't know what my report looks like. I'd have to run the report to do that. But I'm going to turn on the page preview, which will let me see what the visualization looks like. I want to focus the attention of my visualization. I'm going to do that by selecting year in the filter. And I'm going to create a custom filter. And in this case, I know I want to pick the 2018 through 2020 loss events. One of the things I can do with visualizations is remove any elements that really don't add additional value. And in this case, grid lines is a good example. Selecting the visualization, I can turn off the item axis grid lines, and then coming down to the axis value, I can do the same thing. So now the visualization is a little bit cleaner. The other thing I might want to do is just make it a bit more descriptive. So for example, if I looked at net loss and looked at the properties, I can see that it's set to average. So I can see on my visualization, I don't have any indication that in fact this is a average value for net loss. So that might be misleading. People might think it's the total. So what I can do is come over and click on net loss. I now can see the properties. And I can come up and change the label. And I can see that's now reflected in my visualization, giving a more accurate view of the data. Another formatting thing I can do is the placement of the legend. Now, this is a personal preference. I just prefer the legends appearing at the bottom. I find they just read better and it's less distracting. So in this case, I can select the visualization again and going to the bottom, pick the position, and I've moved it to the bottom. Now I'm going to move on to adding a list report. I'm going to start by giving it a title. And if I wanted to, for whatever reason, to break out from my style, I'm going to create a list report. And I'm just going to start double-clicking the columns I want to appear on the report. And one of the things I know I want to do is I'm going to calculate the loan value. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the net loss and the recovery amount together to give me the original loan value. I'm also going to calculate what percentage of the loan value was recovered. At this point, I'm going to remove the net loss amount from my report. I can change my border settings to call out particular data or to, let's say, differentiate sections of a report. So in this case, I'm going to select my headings, select the border. I'm going to add a double line, 3 points. Let's try white and see how that works with the blue. I can also use conditional styles to draw attention to values, selecting the loan recovery amount. So what I want to do is, if the bank says anything below a 20% recovery is really a red flag, I can use conditional styles to make sure that really pops in the report. So what I'm going to do is start to add the ranges that I want conditional stylings to use. So for example, because I'm dealing with percentages, I need to use decimal values. So I'm going to say anything below 15%. I need to click the arrow to say 15% to the lowest value. I want to say that background color should be appearing as red. And then my next range is between 20% and 16%. And I'm going to say that background color should be yellow. And you can see the conditional styling has been applied. And if I want to see what the report would look like, I can run it. That concludes this video on how to use formatting in a report. You've now seen how to use different formatting techniques to call out information in a report. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.